In this video, we will learn about map and dart, and we use map to store key value pairs. So if your requirement is to save key value pairs in your program, then you can use map data structure. Now let's see what is the syntax of defining a map in your dart program. So it is very easy. We just define a var. Let's say I want to define a var named users. Now to define a map, we use the same literal as we used to define a set. We use a pair of curly braces. The difference is this time we define two values for one item because each item will contain a key and a value. And to define a key value pair, we will use colon. On the left, we will write the key, and on the right, we will write the value. And then we will use comma to end the element. Now key and value is also an object, and you can use any type for key and any type for value. For example, for key, I will define the username. Again, I will write John as the name. And let's say we will define the ID of the user as the value. Let's say John has the ID 1. So you can use any data type for key and any data type for value. In this case, I have created a map of type string and integer. Now we can add as many elements as required. So let's say we have Peter of ID 2. And you can see if we write a duplicate value, we get a warning. That is, two keys in a map literal should not be equal. So for keys, we should always use unique values because we will use this key only to fetch the value. So I will write Tony here. I will just define three elements for this map. So we have three values or three elements for this map users. And each element contains a key and a value. Now, if you want to access this first element, then you can use the key of this element to access this data, that is one. So here I can write print and then users, and I can pass the key, and the key is John here. Now this statement will print one. So let's run the code, and we are getting one as the output. To define an empty map, you can use this map literal. So I can define here, let's say names and the pair of curly braces. Now this names is a map. You can see this names is a map, and the key and the value is dynamic. If you want to define key value, then you can write it here like this. For example, I want string and I want int like this. So now we have a map of type string and integer. You can also store integer here and string here. So basically you can use any data type for key and any data type for value. Now, if you want to insert values in this names map, then what you can do is you can simply write names and then square braces and the key value. Because our key is of type int, we can write any key, let's say 8, and equals to, let's say I will put my name. Now, if I will try to access print name 8, it is actually names. Now this will give me my name. If I run the code, I am getting my name, as you can see here. Now the same way, you can insert more elements inside this users map. For example, I can write users. I will put my name equals to, let's say 4. Now if I put my name here, then I will get 4 as the output, as you can see here. So you can add or remove elements from map. To remove an element from the map, you can use remove function. So you can call names.remove and you can pass key. In this case, this names contains only one element and the key is 8. So if I remove that element and I try to access an element that is not available inside the map, let's see what happens. we are getting null. So this is how you can add elements to the map and you can remove elements from the map. If you want to create a constant map, then again you can use the const keyword just before the literal, and now you will not be able to add values to this user's map. Let's run the code and you can see we are getting cannot set value in unmodifiable map. Now the same way, this map also supports spread operator. So if you want to add some other map inside this names map, then you can use that triple dot and then users. Now it will insert all the values from this user's map to this names map. But in this case, it is not possible because this map is of type int and string, and this map is of type string and int. So if I switch the types like string and int, then the error is gone. And now we can use this spread operator to insert a different map to this map. And it will insert all the elements from the users into this names map. Again, you can use the null safety operator if required. I will delete this line. And you can also use if and for, as we did with list and set. So you can write if and then you can put a condition here. And if that condition is true, we will insert a new value. Let's say we will put a new value. And here we will write a condition. For example, I will just hard code the condition here, that is true. It is a Boolean literal. And the same way you can also use for loop here. I will not write it because I have already covered it in the last video. So this is how you can work with map in your Dart program. You can create key value pairs, you can add elements, you can remove elements. You can control how your elements are inserted into map. You can also create a constant map so that it is not modifiable. So that is all for this video, friends. Thanks for watching.